It's moment. I guess it's time.
Yeah. Maggie, Beth, stay close. I see a fence right there. We're gonna jump the wall. Looks like it's surrounded by barbed wire. You get that blanket, Shane?
Yeah. I'll go first. I put the blanket over it.
Alright guys, come on, up and over. Maggie and Beth, they jump over.
Come on.
We look around. We see a bunch of people standing around. There's one lady on the intercom making announcements, practicing.
Hello.
Those who arrive survive. She stands up. She looks at us. Hello. A guy comes out over the balcony. I'm on the right. He sees us. Well. I bet Albert is on perimeter watch again. Welcome to Terminus, the guy says. I know it doesn't look like much in here, but I promise you the welcome wagon is a whole lot nicer. He comes down the stairs. I give Shane a look.
Where is everybody?
Oh, don't worry about that. We have the guards outside, and most of the people are outside on the patio having their brunch right now, so that's where they all are, but come on, show you guys around. Cool. Oh, where are my manners? See, my name is Simon, and this place has been around for a long time. When everything first happened, we took this place over. Luckily, we had these train carts to store supplies, and we didn't have many numbers when we first started here. But you know, the more that became a part of us, the more stronger we got. So you guys came into the back, right? Smart.
Yeah, we did.
Yes, that's smart. But you see. Things like that, you don't have to worry about anything here. We're good people. All we want is just to bring in survivors that have been through a lot. And I can tell by looking at you guys, you have. I can tell by your demeanor, your clothes, your attitudes. It's okay, you're nervous. I get it, we all were. We don't have to be. You see, we're all a family. Isn't that right, Deborah? That's right. She's cooking a steak on the grill. So, I got some business to take care of. So, Deborah, if you would, fix our new friends here a plate. And I'll be back. Hey, before you go, I'm Herschel. This is Shane. These are my daughters, Beth and Maggie. Nice to meet you all. Say, you look like the farmer kind, Herschel. Were you? I was. I could see it in you. You get that style. Oh, and by the way, guys. Before we go any further, we need to check everyone's weapons. If you'll just put them down in front of you. You. We can do that. Take my gun. Put it on the floor. Maggie and Beth, they put theirs down. My guy comes up, he starts to frisk us now. He checks all of us. We're all good. Alright, guys. You're good. He hands our guns back. Here you go. Oh, thank you. I'll get mine. Alright, guys. Well, Deborah, fix our friends here a plate, and I'll be right back. What are you thinking, man?
I don't know yet.
We just got here, man. He's already offering us a free steak and welcoming us with open arms.
He's too nice.
Yeah. I don't know, man. This place is, just give me those vibes. She comes up. What are you guys talking about? Oh. Nothing. We're just talking about how happy we are to finally make it to Terminus. The sanctuary for all, right? That's right.
I gotta ask you. How long you guys put those signs up for?
Oh, those signs. We put those up a couple months ago. We figured it would be an easier way to get people to come here, to find us. Because we know how hard it is out there. And we, you know...
How's your resources?
Our resources are very good, you know. We have scouts to go out every day, scavenge what they can, and they come back. And whatever we have, we put it in the storage crates. We have some behind us right here.
And you find... So you're well on food, huh?
Oh, yes. We are very well on food here.
Because for us,
in fact, sometimes we have too much.
It's kind of not normal. It's hard to find food out there.
Exactly. Which is why Terminus is the best place to be. Now, I see in the past, a lot of people... Well... They tried to take this place over from us. And while we lost people, we got it back. Because we knew that we had to fight to save this place. Because without this place, there is no sanctuary for anyone anymore. We protect people. We take them in. We save them. Excuse me. Do you want a plate?
No. No, thank you.
You sure? You look pretty hungry.
Nah, no, I'm fine.
Well, I'm fine. Okay then.
Can I walk off for a second?
Shane?
I kind of look towards the train carts. I'm just reading what's on them. It has like letterings. Good.
You good, man?
Yeah, I'm good.
How are you doing?
Hi.
Who are you?
My name's Greg. Simon wanted me to give the tour to you guys.
A tour?
Yeah, the tour of the Terminus.
Okay.
So, follow me. I'll show you around. Alright, so this building to the left is where all the magic happens. The main place.
Magic?
Nah, magic. Not that, no, not like, you know, I'm just joking around, not that kind of magic, you know. It's just kind of where the main spot is, where we broadcast and make stuff, you know, signs and stuff, you know, to bring people here.
Okay.
So we'll take you out into the fields where all the other people are. you see a
Don't you want to show us inside?
Simon doesn't want me to show inside right now. He said he'll personally show you guys another time. So, I want to go into the main building at all.
Okay. So what do you guys do here anyway?
Survive, keep people, save people.
Well, I figured that.
We just try to help people, that's all. We're just surviving like you guys. If you look over to the left, that's one of our guard towers up there. We got scouts everywhere.
I see.
We're eventually trying to get our own water source eventually, so we're kind of planning on, trying to make that happen.
I see you guys also got some oil equipment fired up again, right?
Yeah, we've been trying to work on that. It's been kind of, we're in the progress of, making it happen.
Okay.
If you look out to the right, to our right, that's where all people stay, all the families and stuff. We got a bunch of wagons, that move supplies and stuff and all that. Who knows? Maybe one day. What?
How's your weapon inventory?
We got a good bit of we got a good amount of weapons. And this is where just mostly.
You guys got barbed wire around your fences.
Yeah, it's to keep people out. We don't want a lot of people in here, We normally don't like people jumping the fences. We just kind of like them coming through the train tracks.
Right. Yeah,
gotta keep it away from bandits and stuff. But let me ask you guys, where you guys come from? What you guys used to do?
I look at Shane.
We came from up the road the ways. We used to live on a farm. So that got run down. Oh. Man. I guess I can tell by the farmer outfit, For him.
Yeah,
so I guess you guys found each other?
Yeah, you could say that.
Ah. Well, come on, guys. We're all friends here. But yeah, this is Terminus. I could probably maybe show you a little bit more, but I don't know what he wants me to do exactly, because I can't go over there because all the families and stuff. But I mean, I could kind of show you if you want.
No, that's okay. Actually, we're still trying to get a feel for the place. We don't even know if we want to stay yet.
Oh. I mean, we can take you back to the main place if you want.
No, thanks. We can take ourselves back.
Alright. Well, my name's Greg. If you need anything, just yell for Greg and I'll show up.
We appreciate it.
Alright. See you guys later.
Tell you what, man.
I just look at you.
I bet you go find this guy Simon. I'm gonna take a further look around the place, cause I don't know, something don't feel right. I need you to go talk to Simon. You keep him off my back. Sound good?
You can. I'll try to figure out where to talk, but
yeah.
Check the main building.
We're here on someone's radio.
Hey guys, you seen Simon around? Yes. Last I seen, he went up to his office to do some paperwork. Alright, copy that.
Well, where's your answer, man?
Yeah.
He's in the building, but How are you gonna get in there? Well, we are new here, right?
Yeah.
So as newcomers, maybe he's obliged to answer our questions. He wants us to stay. I guess you can bring that point up. Just do anything you can to keep talking. Yeah, just make sure you keep the yarn spinning. I'm gonna look around.
You be safe.
I will.
Excuse me. Is there any chance I can get up there and talk to Simon?
No, sir. No can do. Simon's a busy man. Best to leave him be right now.
I see. Alright, well, thanks for your help. Well, I guess I'll find my own way in. Oh, excuse me, sir. I was just trying to get a good vantage point just to look at the place.
Oh,
sorry to bother you.
No worries, man.
Yeah.
Shane steals the key out of his pocket.
I slowly open up the door, kind of sneak in. Kind of look around. I open up this door.
Whoa! Where did you come from?
Worked my way up here.
Sneaking past my guards. Very disrespectful, but I respect the effort. I'll have a talk with my guards later on. So what can I do you for?
I just wanted to talk to you before, you know, everything else. You never really went full detail about your place.
Well, you see, to be fair, we don't really know you guys. And see, our friend Greg, didn't he give you guys a tour?
Yeah, it wasn't really a good tour. Didn't really show us a lot. I have a couple questions for you.
What questions have you, Shane?
How many people are here exactly?
Oh, we have lots here. In fact, we have at least 50 people.
50 people, huh? And you can feed all those people every day.
Absolutely.
Going out and getting food.
Yes.
That's just
because our runners, he stands up, they put their lives on the line every day to get us food, things we need.
But that doesn't add up, though.
I don't follow you.
I have 4 people in my group, and we are barely get food out there. But you can feed 50 people a day by scavenging. It just doesn't add up.
Well, you see, Shane, if your hunger is strong enough, then you will do whatever it takes to make sure that your people are fed. A man's got to eat.
Let me ask you something. How many walkers have you killed?
Well, golly, you know, I haven't been able to keep track. It's been so many.
Okay. How many people have you killed?
He looks at you with a confused face. None. Why?
That's my third question. Why?
Well, I find killing to be distasteful. Only the feeblest of men kill. But you see, we don't have to because We are a civilized society here. We bring civilization back to this world. Hence why we call this place a sanctuary.
Not my first time hearing that word.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
You know, Shane, but, he stands up. He looks out the window. I can tell by the way you carry yourself. You were perhaps a former leader, correct? The big man in charge, right?
You so, can say that.
From man to man, leader to leader. I don't recommend telling me how to provide for my people and questioning how I provide for my people. With all due respect.
Well, with now, all due respect.
Haven't I shown you respect by allowing you to come into our community through the back like bandits and welcome you with open arms? Isn't that respect enough? Giving you a free tour? Offering you food? Haven't I shown you enough respect?
I mean, you showed me something.
And then you want to march, and then you want to sneak into my office and question me about how I care for my people. Is that the kind of man you are?
What kind of man I am is, I don't understand how you're so nice to people in this world.
Well, would you prefer me to be a monster that steals things, kills people, hurts them? Well, he looks at you, into your eyes. Or maybe that was a part of your past. Right? You kind of get angry at him.
Alright. I know what kind of man you are.
You got the wrong idea about me, Shane. I'm just a man trying to do right by the people I care about. You get a flashback to what the governor said. Now, you see, things may seem off to you. Things may be hard to understand. But here at Terminus, the only thing that you need to understand, he walks up to you, is that we care about our people. And we will do whatever it takes to defend them.
Yeah. Now, same here.
If you want to leave, you can. This is not a prison. But we would love you to stay. The more the merrier.
Yeah, I just wanted to have a talk, that's all.
Appreciate that. I respect your concern. If I came into a place and they welcomed me with open arms, you know, I would be questioning things too.
Yeah.
But still, it's best to leave other people's business out of your business. A guard comes in. Hey, how the hell did you get in here? It's okay. It's okay. Shane, we will have plenty of time to talk later, but as you can see, I have lots of paperwork to do. So, if you wouldn't mind, guard, escort him out for me. Come on. He grabs you. I'm outside the terminus. Facility now. I'm in the woods close to him. What the hell is this? I'm taking my gun out. See a bunch of tools and stuff on the wall. I see a lantern in the corner. I grab it. What the hell is this place? Jesus. I see chains on the wall. What the hell? I see a missing poster. I'm getting kind of terrified. What is this place? Son of a bitch! I fall. Shane's thinking about everything that he was told.
What the hell? You good, man? What? Herschel,
we got
what?
A problem.
What is it? What?
We got a problem.
What?
I was exploring, and I found a basement. These people, they are not who they say they are. There's something worse. We need to get out of here now.
Yeah, I tried to talk to Simon, and he was acting a little strange.
No, he knows.
About... knows what?
He knows what he's done. All of a sudden...
what?
He comes up behind us. What are you guys talking about?
Oh, we're
turn around.
Just talk about how we just talked, you know, me and you.
See a couple of guards around him. I don't know, it's kind of suspicious of you guys over here talking off from everyone.
I believe.
Herschel. Why do you look so panicked, man?
That's you know what exactly. I was just about to ask him.
You know exactly what you done. What are you talking about, farmer man? What have we done? Do I even need to explain it? Or do you want me to show you myself? Shane, is your friend here always this, paranoid?
Not normally.
Listen to me, you son of a bitch. You know what's out there. In that basement, the heads, the torsos, the severed arms, the skulls, the posters.
The hell are you talking about, Herschel?
These people. There's a reason they have a good food source, Shane. Think about it. No other group just has food on standby like them. They don't ever have to worry about running out of food because... I look at you. We are the food. You realize? I've heard just about enough from you guys. It's come clear to me that you don't trust us anymore. So?
We'll just leave.
I'm afraid that's not gonna happen.
You said we can leave any time.
We're leaving. The guards aim their guns at us. Herschel. What do you want? Where are my daughters? You didn't answer the question. He ducks down. Shane, get in there. We're gonna find Beth and Maggie.
Mom! Keep going, keep going!
Come on! Beth, Maggie, where are you?
Go.
Maybe they're inside. Where's my daughter? Where's my daughter, you son of a bitch? Get up! Where are they? You, come here. Come here. Where's my daughter? Tell me. I got time for this. All of a sudden, I tried to go up the back again. They cut us off. Damn, they're coming from the back. Come on. Back to the
front. Back.
All of a sudden, running. A big guy steps in our way.
Oh, what the hell? Shit.
He has a hammer in his hand. The guards around him. They all surround us now. Guns down. Simon catches up to us. Put him down, boys. Do what he says. Put me on the ground. Here, bring my daughters out. Don't you hurt them. Shut up, old man.
Good morning, mister.
Now, you guys have caused a lot of chaos in our home today. But I'm still gonna be a reasonable guy. If he gives Maggie and Beth back, I comfort him. Here's what's gonna happen. You guys are gonna step back into that train car behind you. Here's the order. Ringleader, farmer, and his daughters. That order.
Good morning.
Don't make us kill you now. Just go. Give him the death stare.
I get in the train cart.
Sweet Lord.
Go, old man. My daughters? Go, girls. They come to the car with me. We're all in the car now. They lock the doors behind us.
Oh, man.
I should have known.
Fine.
You didn't see what I saw, Shane. I've never seen anything like that. They were eating people. Good God. Daddy, what do you mean they were eating people?
Didn't you guys eat the food?
We did. Beth starts throwing up. Jesus.
Now what?
I don't know. There's no way out of here. They got guards everywhere.
I started looking through the kind of through the shrink door for the cracks. We hear something. What's that?
I don't know.
Turn around. Who the hell are you?
Name's Dutch. Dutch Vanderland. These are my people. A blonde lady comes up behind me. And a black guy. This is Lee. And Andrea. What's your names?
I'm Shane. That's Herschel. Maggie and Beth.
Pleasure to meet you all. Looks like you found yourselves in the same predicament as us.
Yeah. But it's alright. They're gonna feel pretty stupid when they find out.
Find out what?
They're fucking with the wrong people.